Hey guys, welcome to the fifth episode of Products Hits and Misses. The first two products that I'll talk about are the products that really, really pushed me to make this video. And starting with the first, it is Neutrogena Oil Free Moisture for Combination Skin. This is how it looks. It's alcohol free, it's allergy tested, and it's fragrance free. So it's perfect for people with sensitive skin. This is the packaging that it comes in. So this is how it looks. The locking system is another thing that I really appreciate about this product. So you take it and you just twist it and it gets locked, and you twist it back and it unlocks, so I won't push it down. Unlike other pump packagings, which are kind of like you have to push them down and then turn them for them to get locked, this doesn't work like that. It's very simple, it's very easy. And because in the other packagings, when you push it down and turn it, a lot of product comes out whether you need it or not. And if it doesn't get locked in the first go, you keep pushing it and keep doing it. And I have, honestly, trust me, wasted a lot of products like that with a lot of faulty packagings. So this is wonderful that way. The only thing I don't like is I would have preferred if this had a cap on top of this so as to protect this nozzle and so that the thing doesn't get dry. Apart from this, I love the packaging. It's really simple, it's really elegant and sweet and sophisticated. The packaging is very sturdy, so there's no problem of spilling and all. I've traveled with this and nothing has spilled out and it's been perfect. I've tried it in dry weather as well as humid and it worked perfectly for both climates. I was breaking out using anything and everything, from Johnson Baby lotion to Nivea to anything and everything. I would just break out like crazy. Probably my skin has changed, or I don't know what is it, but I've been really, hardly anything suits me these days, and this one really did, so I'm really thankful. And people with sensitive skin, please go try it out. You don't have to use much, actually. It's just one pump and you're done, and that's great about this. It cost me $2.99, so $300. It says it's an oil-free formula that absorbs quickly and doesn't clog pores, and which can cause breakouts. And it's true, touch wood, it hasn't caused any breakouts so far. And it's allergy tested, so, you know, I mean, a lot of them are, but somehow, you know, it worked really well for me. The second product is the Maybelline Colossal Liner. This is the product, and this is how the tip looks. So I love this product. I'll show you a demo of it. It can go really fine. So yeah, oh, look at the artwork I've done on my hand. So anyway, it can go really thin to medium to super thick, whatever you like. And it's really comfortable. I've never been okay with felt tip eyeliners. They're too stiff for me, they just don't work. But this one is super flexible. If I could show you, like, look at the tip, it's really bendy, and I really love that about it. Winged eye looks and all of that is not a problem at all. There's no dipping required, there's no spillage problem. It's just perfect for, again, all climates. The only thing is it's not water resistant, it's washable, which is okay on one hand, but it doesn't wash clear, so you have to take it off with a cleansing milk and then wash your face, or vice versa. And after a long day, sometimes it can, if you have watery eyes, then it can get a little lightened from the edge. Otherwise, it does not budge. It's a semi-matte, semi-glossy kind of finish, and I love the fact that obviously it's quick dry, so you don't have to wait for it to dry. Except that if you make a mistake, then you have to be really quick in fixing it. So other than that, I really love this eyeliner. So guys, go try it out. It's a little on the higher side coming from Maybelline and the Colossal range. It's $4.25, but it's almost equal, or rather much lesser than the other pen liners that you find out there. And it's way better. It's not stiff. It's not stiff like a marker. It's flexible and it's really nice. This is the third product, the L'Oreal Total Repair 5 Hair Serum. And this is the packaging for the same. I don't know why it's like a huge ass packaging and the bottle is kind of tiny. Anyway, so the reason I had to buy this is because of another product that I bought, about which I will talk in this video only, just in a while. And this has been working pretty well for me. It doesn't make my hair greasy at all. And it makes it feel really soft and smooth, and I don't feel it's done much for my hair in terms of making it better. If you're using a shampoo that really dries out your hair and makes it super frizzy and crazy, I think you should definitely give it a try, and it really helps a lot without making your hair greasy and all of that. It makes your hair really manageable, makes it look really polished, and it doesn't impart a gloss to a great extent, but otherwise for healthier feeling and softer feeling hair, this one really works wonders. We'll come to the okay or mediocre products. I'll start with the Forest Essential Replenishing Face Gel in Punch Push. The packaging is really nice and fancy, and it's got a cover and it's almost finished. It smells really fresh. Initially it may seem a little strong and a little like incense sticks, but after a while you get used to it. It's a little Ayurvedic smell. There's hardly anything left in this because I kind of dropped it, and yeah, a lot of it got spilled. But it's an okay product because it's quite expensive. I don't remember the price. It did not do much for my skin as such. It did not help it feel hydrated much, and it kind of made me break out a little, so that's a little scary. I don't expect Forest Essentials to work like that, and I had really high expectations. I really want to like it, but it didn't do anything for my skin as such. So yeah, no, didn't work. The second one is the Schwarzkopf Gliss Hair Repair. It's again a decent product, not too bad, not too good. I feel it does save your hair, but it can make your hair feel a little heavy and a little limp, so that is the problem. It's 550 bucks for one bottle of 200 ml, and I love the pump, the spray pump. It's really convenient. It says it smoothens hair and reduces frizz, which is kind of true. It kind of does that. But it says it damages from heat and provides it with suppleness and shine. I'm not too sure about the whole suppleness and shine thing, because the only problem I feel is that it really weighs your hair down, and a lot of us have fine hair, and doesn't really work so much for that. Otherwise, it's not bad. It's by Schwarzkopf, so again, I really want to like it, but the fact that it really weighs my hair down is a problem, and because if I don't use quite a bit of it, it will not help. It will not seep in to my hair, and it will eventually not provide with the heat protectant whole thing. This is how it looks if you want a closer look for this. The third one is another product that I really wanted to like, which was the Kazi Herbal Face Pack with Neem. This is how it looks. I got it from the main Kazi store here in Delhi in CP. And it's a powder which looks like this, if you can see. Okay. It smells herbally, so nothing big about that. But it kind of made my face feel very dry. And when I used it with rose water, when I used it with honey, it was still okay, but it did not do anything for my skin. Like, it didn't clear it out, it didn't make my complexion anything nicer, my skin didn't feel any better. It was just like a psychological thing that you're okay, it's a product and you're using it and it's herbal. I did not like it at all. It's 50 grams and it's 60 bucks, so it's not very expensive. But if it doesn't work for you, then, you know, what's the point of even spending that much? The last section now is the duds, like the absolute duds. And I will start with my first dud, which is the Matrix Biolage Fiber Strong Strengthening Shampoo, which looks like this. It's for 300 bucks and it is 200 ml. It's quite expensive for a shampoo and it's horrible. It's really scary. It cleanses your hair well, that is good, but it's super cleanses. It's like washing your hair with dishwash. So I might as well take Pril and wash my hair instead of washing with this. It really dries out your hair, and that is the exact reason that I told you that I had to buy this. This is the reason that I had to buy something extra, because this was killing my hair. It made my hair super dry and really scary. So I don't know, I didn't feel any kind of strengthening in my hair at all. I just felt my hair feel really brittle. The second product is the Kazi Herbal Face and Body Wash in Neem and Tulsi. So this is how it looks. And it's 120 bucks for 210 ml. The packaging is as usual, very simple Kazi stuff. The smell is again very herbal, like Kadi. My mother has been using this, but I don't like it. It's not foamy, which is okay, but it does not, like, my skin does not feel clean. Like, I don't feel clean after washing my face with it or taking a bath with it. So I feel like I don't feel fresh or clean. So I think the whole point of a cleanser is missing here, because if you don't feel clean after washing your face or taking a bath with that, then what is the point? So that's why it was a dud for me. It did not clear out my breakouts. It did not improve my skin, which in fact happened with the Garnier Neem one, which I have mentioned in previous videos of mine. These were all my products, hits and misses, guys. And if you have tried any of these products, or if you want to try any of these products, let me know. Let me know your feedback. If you agree with any of my comments on these products, or if you don't agree, just, you know, still share them with me. And let me know if you have any other requests for me, any videos that you want me to do specifically, and I'll see you in the next product, hits and misses.